Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 14.4 and iOS 14.5 Beta 2 have been out for a minimum of 2 weeks and longer with 14.4. And so I wanted to talk about the overall experience, when to expect the next update, and some bugs and issues and more. But first, I wanted to talk about one additional feature I hadn't mentioned in previous videos. So if you go into music, for example, now this may show up for you on 14.4 as well, but I haven't seen that, but we'll try that in a moment. But if you go into music, for example, and you go to an artist page, in some instances, a pop-up will show up. I wasn't able to get it to show up with Anne Berlin, for example, but when I went to a more popular artist like Taylor Swift, I was able to get it to pop up and I took a screenshot. So you can see it says, listen to a station featuring only this artist by pressing play. And so you can listen to a station with that, and it's just a new pop-up I saw. I wasn't able to get it when I went to a less popular artist, for example. So let's try it on iOS 14.4. We'll go to music. And we'll search for the same artist here and see if it pops up, and it doesn't. So it seems like it's only in 14.5 beta 2, but it's a new feature, it seems like. Now with iOS 14.4, I'm running it on my iPhone 11 Pro Max, and I have iOS 14.5 beta 2 on the other devices here, the iPhone 12 Pro Max, along with my 12.9 inch iPad Pro from 2020 and the iPhone 11. But with iOS 14.4, I've got continuous emails, continuous messages on Twitter telling me about continued issues going on with this update and wondering when the next one's going to come out. So for example, there was an issue that my daughter messaged me about today on an iPhone 10. She was using a 10 and Face ID all of a sudden out of the blue stopped working. So I had her try and reset it, going into her settings and then going into her passwords, for example, wherever that is here. There we go. You've got password or Face ID and passcode. When you go into that, I had her reset it and it didn't work. She had to try it again. It didn't work. I had to have her reboot in order for that to work. So that was an issue that seems to be happening, and someone else has messaged me about the same thing. And then the next thing you saw is when I swiped out to go home, there was some lag. This is continuing to go on with iOS 14.4 and isn't fixed, as well as the green tint issue that seems to be there still. And some are saying they're having terrible battery. However, 70% are saying they're having good battery with 14.4. So it really varies from the device to device. And on this one, I haven't been using this regularly, and you'll see it's acting a little bit slow, and that's because it's installing a ton of updates since I hadn't turned it on in a while. But just to show you the battery health, this phone's at 93%. This was used for a little bit, about a year, maybe a little bit more than that, regular, full-time, charged every single night. It was my main phone, and this is the first time I've turned it on in a couple of weeks, but it is running 14.4. So the battery life on this for some is great, for some is not great, but there's continued lag, keyboard lag, and the main thing I hear the most is issues with Bluetooth connectivity, whether that be with AirPods, AirPods switching between iPhone and iPad back and forth, or even other things like reception happening where it's just not connecting, or maybe people are dropping calls. There's also CarPlay connectivity issues, and some people, the screen stops responding to touch. So iOS 14.4 seems to have a lot of issues in it and continues to get worse for some. For others, people say it's great and has phenomenal battery life. So it's really hit or miss. It depends on the application you have installed. So maybe you have Facebook. I find that uses a tremendous amount of power for some reason. So if you uninstall that, usually it fixes it. So when you have the same phone with different apps, sometimes you'll have different experiences. But for most, it seemed 70% or so were having better battery life. But the people that have worse battery life will always be the loudest and comment about it the most. But that seems to be mostly fixed with all of those bugs for the most part with iOS 14.5 beta 2. So with 14.5 beta 2, it's not 100% perfect, but it does seem to fix the green tint issue, as well as the HDR flickering, or where the pixels look like they're backlit. They no longer look like that. So I'm not able to replicate the green tint issue, and those that were actually showing me that problem that were having it no longer can replicate that as well. So that's a good sign. It will show up from time to time in different places, but it seems to be fixed for the most part. Now, AirDrop is working great compared to iOS 14.5 beta 1. And what I mean by that is with beta 1, it was really slow and didn't AirDrop quickly. So if I go into AirDrop and share maybe this photo here, you'll see it sends nice and fast. So no issues there. It seems to be fixed, and I haven't had any issues since, and it works great. However, there are some problems with iOS 14.5 beta 2, and the most recent one I've experienced really has to do with mail. And mail has been great, mostly for me, but all of a sudden fetch email stopped working. Push email sort of works, but fetch email doesn't show up properly. It shows up properly on the iPad Pro without a problem, running the same version, but for whatever reason, it's just not showing up on my iPhone 12 Pro Max. So I don't know what it is. I've tried rebooting, I've tried hard resetting it, and it doesn't seem to have fixed it. So there's something strange there. And of course, you want to report that in feedback to make sure Apple takes a look at it. Now, also there's other issues. YouTube picture in picture has stopped working again in Safari for most people. So YouTube must have changed something there. That's not on iOS, but it's just kind of annoying if you're used to using that. And also if you're using the EQ for music, it's not working properly. You can change between the EQ settings if you go into your settings here. And I do wish Apple would actually add this to the music app. It's kind of strange that it's in here buried. But if you use the EQ, change it to electronic or acoustic or whatever you'd like, it doesn't make any difference and it seems to not do anything really. So again, make sure you report that if you have it and you're having that issue. So there are additional issues in this. I think they've fixed the green tint issue. They've fixed a lot of the lag issues. I haven't had a single time in weeks with this lagging when I close an app. It's been super fast. Everything's been really great as far as performance. iOS 14.4 has not been that way. So there's definitely a difference between both of them, with 14.4 needing an update for sure. So whether you're using the iPhone 11 with 14.5 beta 2 or maybe on an iPhone 7, it seems to be much better in general with most things. It's fixed most of those main bugs with iOS 14.4, at least from what I'm hearing from most people. Now let's take a quick look at the iPad with iPadOS 14.5 beta 2. I've been using this full time. Like I said, this is my main device when I'm not making videos, and I use this for researching and notes and things for these videos instead of my computer. And the good thing is it's been nice and fast. It's super fast scrolling. I haven't had a single app crash. It's been working as expected, and I haven't had a single bug with the exception of battery life. So battery life on the iPad continues to be poor. I've done a full restore, reset, and if I go down to, go up to battery, in battery here, you'll see that it was last charged to 97% at 2:40 p.m. today. Now, to be fair, I did play a little bit of gaming on this today, and I'm down to 57%. That's pretty bad, really, considering I've only used it for a couple hours. So really, you should be getting about 10 hours of battery life on this. I'm getting about 4 or 5. So it's about half of what it should be. And I don't think it's because the battery's degraded or anything. I just think there's something wrong with the latest updates with the iPad. And I've seen a lot of you complain about the same thing. But performance-wise and everything else, it's been fine. No bugs with the Apple Pencil. Nothing like that. Everything seems to be working fine. I even tried removing the Apple Pencil, like many of you suggested, to see if that would help, and it didn't seem to make a difference. So there's definitely some weird bugs in it. And if it continues to happen, it could be some apps I'm using, I suppose, but I'll delete it and try over again if that continues to be a problem. Now, battery life on the iPhone with iOS 14.5 beta 2, I think is pretty good. And I say I think because I usually go to bed with about 50% of my battery life left. I do use multiple phones from time to time when I'm testing things out. But if we go to my battery life, we'll go to battery health. You'll see I'm at 100%. And this is a 12 Pro Max since launch day that I've been using. And like I've said many times, the updates don't affect the battery health. They just remeasure it. So they're remeasuring the physical capability of the battery. So I haven't had any issues with it yet. And if it goes down, it's normal. 80% after 2 years is normal, according to Apple. Now let's take a look at the last 10 days since I've been running this for a couple of weeks so you can see. So if we take a look at yesterday, I got 2 hours and 52 minutes of screen on time and used about 50% of the battery life. That's not great. 2 hours and 10 minutes the day before, 3 hours and 26 minutes the day before that, and 3 hours and 20 minutes the day before that. And I'm using about 40 to 50% of the battery. So if you double that, assuming I use the entire battery, I'm only getting about 6 hours of battery life. Now, the thing that's strange to me about this, and others have reported, is that their screen time does not add up to what they're actually using it. And I wonder if that's the case for this, because like I said, I still go to bed early in the morning, usually with 50% or more left, meaning that I've used the phone like I have for years, basically the same thing, and I'm getting poor battery life. Maybe it's Twitter that's using the power, since Twitter is using a lot of power. Maybe it's not, but at this point, I'm not sure what's causing it, but it seems to be an issue, and hopefully it's just a discrepancy here. But one thing I would love to see in iOS 15 or future updates is instead of the last 24 hours, tell me how much screen on time I've used since it's been last charged to 100%. So something like that would be much better. Now, over the past few weeks, I've talked about Apple releasing an incremental update before we see iOS 14.5 released to the public. And the reason for this is Apple stopped signing iOS 14.3. And consistently over the past few years, when they stopped signing, say, a public version such as 14.3, leaving only one version to be able to downgrade to or install, that means we'll see a public release fairly soon. Usually we'll see two public releases available at once to be able to restore your phone or downgrade to. When it's not signed, it means you can't downgrade or install that version anymore. So when we see that sort of behavior from Apple, generally it means we'll see an update pushed out to the public within 2 weeks. This is seemingly changed from what we saw last year. So whether or not Apple has changed something, maybe they're just waiting to make sure it's right, or maybe they're just waiting for iOS 14.5 to be available to the public, where they'll push a bunch of fixes and features at once, since we'll have those new emoji, the face unlock with wearing a face mask when you're using an Apple Watch, for example, that sort of thing. And so this coming week, I would expect iOS 14.5 beta 3, or maybe even release candidate. It just depends how many Apple has planned, but I would expect it early in the week. So we can expect a beta, since we're on a 2 week cycle. Generally we'll have 2 weeks, then we'll get down to 1 week, and then we'll see a final release. Now, again, Apple has been changing up what they've been doing compared to what they did over years. So this could change, of course, but generally it seems like we're on a 2 week cycle compared to beta 1 to beta 2, maybe beta 3 or RC next. So I think beta 3, but we'll have to wait and see. And then I would expect a final release of 14.5 later in the month after Apple maybe shows off some new products somewhere in the middle of March. So it's expected to have some products shown, but not necessarily a keynote from Apple or an event. So I would look forward to 14.5 beta 2 or beta 3 rather this week, and 14.5 releasing to the public later in March. It's possible they could push it to April, of course, but without a small incremental update in between that before the final release, it'll be kind of strange. But either way, look for that and I'll keep you updated. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the YouTube community poll, since I didn't do a new one, but I did want to talk about the ones that were existing already because there's so many more votes on them. So with iOS 14.5 beta 2, you'll see the votes have 38,000 votes for that one. And if we go down to 14.4, there's 49,000 votes. And so with iOS 14.4, you'll see there was 57% that say it's great. It continues to increase in numbers. 4% are saying it's terrible. 13% are saying okay, but some bugs. And then 16% are on 14.3 or older. Most people are on 14.4. So let's take a look at just a couple comments that have been left, since there's 949 comments at the time of this video, which is incredible. So thanks to everyone that voted and commented. And you'll see here, the first one from Mitchell says, starting to see problems on my 7 Plus iPhone, stutter when pushing up or down, lost my voicemail key at the bottom of the screen, error 1035, I think is the number. App starting to disappear, all slowly appeared since I updated. And so people are starting to slowly see 14.4 become worse, which is kind of strange. If we go down a few more, let's see what we have here. William says, on iOS 14.4, iPhone 12 Pro, lots of bugs with AirPods Pro Bluetooth connectivity. Whenever I'm on FaceTime and put my AirPods in my ears, it ends the FaceTime. Also still having stutter and a bit of overheating. So again, strange problems that just all of a sudden start to crop up. Some people had them from the beginning, some have not. Cato says, I have iPhone 12 Pro Max. 14.4 isn't too bad, but I'm honestly waiting until stability with 14.5 increases so that I can get the modem update. I've been having some intermittent connectivity issues on cellular and Wi-Fi alike. Regardless, still pretty good, aside from occasional reset needed to connect. So again, those cellular and Wi-Fi issues. And we'll take a look at two more on 14.4, then we'll look at 14.5 beta 2. Dinesh says, iOS 14.4 is running great on my iPhone 12. No stutter, no lag, even the battery life is great. Probably the best update so far. And you'll see that was from 3 weeks ago, so it's possible it got worse since. And then Angela says, I updated my 11 Pro Max and 6S Plus to 14.4 the other day, and they're amazing. So it's very mixed depending on who you ask, and people's experiences vary depending on device as well. So we'll take a look at 14.5 beta 2 that I posted a week ago, and you'll see only 17% are saying it's great. 3% say it's terrible, 7% say okay, but some bugs, and 61% are saying that they're on the older version. So that makes sense, and 12% are on Android. Now there's 353 comments, which again is incredible. So let's go ahead and take a look at the past few of them. Alexander says, using iPhone 11 Pro Max and having Bluetooth problems while AirPods Pro and Apple Watch are connected to phone. AirPods keep disconnecting or sometimes sound is cutting off while listening to music, and battery is much worse than Beta 1 even 14.4. And again, I see this mixed depending on who it is, but it seems to be very different. Ash says the 14.5 beta 2 caused so much of lag on my iPhone that I had no other option of opting out of the beta program. Also, I faced frequent app crashes and my screen won't work sometimes. Be curious to know what phone that is. Marlon said, great on my 6S Plus. Battery life is better, can last 8 to 10 hours of screen on time, much better than Beta 1, but there's a few stuttering when switching or closing apps. The only issue I got is my phone heating up when I plug it in, but overall it's better than previous betas. And it will always heat up a little bit when plugging in, as the battery will get warm, especially if you're fast charging versus maybe using a 5-watt adapter. It will definitely make a difference. But when you plug it in, batteries always get warm. So that's just the way that works when you're pushing energy into a battery. Jeff said, pretty great on my 11 Pro Max. Battery is okay, but only shows the last 2 days in the last 10-day tab. Not sure why. If you did a full restore or maybe a hard reset, it possibly could have wiped that data. If it was a full restore, it would have wiped it. But otherwise, it's strange that that would disappear like that. We'll take a look at two more. And let's see. Sandy says, the battery life is down. There are scrolling stuttering issues. I have never posted in the comments, but this beta has been so bad for me on my iPhone 12 Pro Max that I had to write. I've done a hard reboot at least 5 times. This normally solves the issues, but not this time. And Chesapeake in Ohio 1309 says, the latest beta has been decent, except that the battery performance is very poor on my iPhone 8 Plus, which still has 100% health, and my iPad Air 3G or third generation. So it's very hit or miss. Like I said, many people are going to see very different experiences depending on what apps you're running, how you use your phone, and more. But so far for me, like I said, it's been smooth on my phone, but I have had those few little issues. That's it for iOS 14.5 Beta 2. I'm really looking forward to 14.5 Beta 3 and then finally a public release. I don't really expect any intermittent release like I talked about earlier with 14.4.1, but at this point, we just don't know. Apple's really been changing it up lately, but I'm looking more forward to see what iOS 14.5 has, maybe when it's fully released, as well as iOS 15 with hopefully some icon redesigns. And I talked more about that in a video the other day. Now, if you found anything else or you have a different experience I haven't mentioned or you didn't see in any of those comments, let me know in the comments below. And if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already, though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.